What could my fast heart rate mean? Ever wonder that when you feel your heart racing or someone takes your pulse and they tell you that your heart rate is fast? It can be a little alarming, but don't worry. We're gonna break it down together and explore how you can keep your heart healthy without any added stress. The medical term for a fast heart rate is tachycardia. Normally, your heart beats between 60 and 100 beats per minute. Tachycardia simply means your heart is beating faster than that, over 100 beats per minute when you're at rest. Though there can sometimes be an underlying medical condition that causes tachycardia, it's often no cause for concern. There are three types of tachycardia. The first is called supraventricular tachycardia, or SVT. This is a fast heart rate starting in the upper chambers of your heart. It's pretty common in kids and teens, and often it's not dangerous. SVT can be caused by different factors. One is genetics. Some types of SVT are present at birth and may run in families. Another is lifestyle habits. These include smoking, excessive caffeine or alcohol consumption, and drug use. Certain health conditions can cause SVT. These include heart disease, lung disease, thyroid disease, obstructive sleep apnea, and even pregnancy can cause SVT. Some medications, such as those used to treat asthma, allergies, and colds, can increase the risk of SVT. Another big factor is stress. Physical or emotional stress can trigger SVT. If you ever feel your heart racing, it might just be SVT. Most people with SVT can manage it with simple strategies, and it often doesn't mean anything serious. The second type is called sinus tachycardia. This happens when your heart rate increases as a normal response to things such as exercise, excitement, or stress. If your heart beats faster occasionally, like when you're anxious or excited, that's typically normal and nothing to worry about. The third one is ventricular tachycardia, or VT. VT is a faster heartbeat starting in the lower chambers of your heart. While it can be more serious, it's less common and usually related to other heart conditions. Some things that can cause VT are a prior heart attack, any heart condition that caused scarring of heart tissue called structural heart disease, poor blood flow to the heart muscle due to coronary artery disease, heart problems present at birth, changes in levels of body minerals called electrolytes. These include potassium, sodium, calcium, and magnesium. Side effects of medicines can cause VT. Use of stimulants such as cocaine or methamphetamine can cause VT. So those are the different types of tachycardia. But what can we do to try and keep our heart rate under control? Here's some tips. Stay active. Regular physical activity is fantastic for your heart. It helps keep everything in check and boosts overall health. Find activities you enjoy, whether it's sports, dancing, my personal favorite, or just walking with friends. Eat well. A balanced diet with lots of fruits, vegetables, and whole grains supports a healthy heart. Don't worry, it's okay to indulge once in a while, but focus on nutritious foods most of the time. Watch your caffeine. Too much caffeine can increase your heart rate. Drink coffee in moderation. Watch your alcohol. If you drink alcohol, consume in moderation. Keep hydrated with water. Manage stress. Find ways to relax and unwind. Stress can increase your heart rate, so make time for activities that help you feel good, like hobbies or hanging out with friends, or find a minute and take a time out for yourself. Regular checkups. Even if you're feeling fine, regular checkups with your doctor are a smart way to stay on top of your health. They help catch any issues early so you can take action if needed. Listen to your body. If you notice anything unusual about your heart rate or just feel off, talking to a healthcare professional can provide peace of mind and guidance. Remember, a racing heart may be a natural response or it could indicate a big problem. It's often just your body's response to different situations. With a few simple steps, you can keep your heart healthy and reduce any worries. Take these tips to heart and let's keep our hearts happy and healthy together. If you have questions about health conditions, I'd love to hear from you. Comment below, hit subscribe, and if you'd like to donate to the American Heart Association and support this important work, click on that link. And join me here next time for Answers You Can Trust.